at Cranfield, we're aiming to be net zero by 2030. We've been working for the last decade on this, and we're well over 50% there already, which is wonderful. We've got a long way to go, but we are confident we can make it. Working with Salix Finance has been really, really positive in terms of driving our ambition forward. We've worked with them on both small projects, but also in big infrastructure projects, which include major decarbonisation projects.
The solar farm you can see behind me here was put in 2018. And that was through a Salix loan. Since then, through the public sector decarbonisation scheme, we've installed an extension to that. So we've now got just short of 1.5 megawatts of solar panels.
Converting the old hangars, we're basically putting a box within the hangars to make them more airtight. Cost is really important for the university as energy costs are rising, and to manage energy within these large buildings is extremely difficult. So we're looking at ways to manage the heating and also the workings of the building at the same time. We'll be looking at the residential side, so we'll be looking at improving the housing, student accommodation, providing air source heat pumps to the residential areas, and also removing gas boilers.
Working with Cranfield has been amazing. It's great to see the drive that Gareth and the team has to install energy efficiency technologies to further decarbonise the campus.
We've got to reduce the amount of fossil fuels we burn. We've got to ensure that actually where we are using energy, we're using it as efficiently as possible, and make sure that we're not actually releasing CO2 to the excess extent that we are at the present time.